La Burrera is a remote village in the mountains of southern Honduras. About 33 families call this small valley along the Gran Liore River home. The river bisects the tiny village, and for most of the year, it isn't much more than a small stream and the center of life in the bustling community. However, during the summer rainy season, the river waters can rise up to 2 meters, and even more during devastating weather events, such as 1998's Hurricane Mitch. When the water rises, the river becomes impassable, and half the village is effectively cut off from the rest of the world. It is not uncommon for residents to be left stranded from their families for many days, and for children to be unable to attend school. In March of 2008, Bridges to Prosperity came to La Burrera to help the residents build a new type of suspension footbridge, which will ensure the river is traversable during the highest floods. Sponsored by Ross Construction of Palo Alto and Ayuda en Acción, the suspension bridge was a prototype designed to examine the engineering and logistic challenges of constructing such a bridge using locally available tools and materials. Not only will the La Burrera Bridge help the residents access schools, markets, jobs, and clinics, but this new bridge design can be built elsewhere to cross rivers previously considered impractical to bridge. Whereas the standard suspended bridge design is well suited for gorges, previously there was no sustainable design available for crossing rivers located in flat floodplains. Now there is. Bridges to Prosperity estimates that of the 500,000 footbridges needed by developing nations worldwide, about 200,000 lay in floodplains. The La Burrera Bridge will allow Bridges to Prosperity to greatly expand their work and training. Because it is the prototype bridge, Bridges to Prosperity encountered a number of unforeseen engineering challenges during the construction. Assembled while lying level, the two support towers were then to be erected into place using ropes with the mechanical aid of what is known as a gin pole. During the first lift of the east tower, the gin pole fell away, resulting in the immediate collapse of the tower. The impact shattered one of the tower's legs and distorted one of the steel shoes. A new pole was quickly ordered and installed, and the shoe was repaired by a local welder. The next day, as the repairs were underway, the West Tower was lifted with a series of winches, using insight gained from the first tower's collapse. Then, the East Tower was lifted again with a now fully mastered system of redundant procedures. Once the tower footings were secured and the heavy main cables were lifted into place, the bridge became rigid and solid, and work began in earnest on the bridge's span. Suspenders were hung from the main cables, and these in turn held up the cross beams onto which the decking would be assembled. All hands pitched in as the residents were eager to see their new bridge finished. The span of the bridge was soon completed, with Chun, one of the community leaders, holding the honor of hammering in the last of the decking. He in turn escorted Casimiro, the village's oldest resident, in the bridge's ceremonial first crossing. With this new bridge, the community of La Burrera can eventually grow from a village to a town and lift themselves from the ranks of the poor to the middle class. All of this is dependent upon access to education for their children. Thanks to the design efforts of engineer Jeremy Johannesson and the sponsorship and Honduras construction support team from Ross Construction, this new, highly efficient, and sustainable bridge will help expand the mission to twice as many river crossings worldwide as before. The impact of this bridge will be felt far beyond the schools and roads surrounding La Burrera.